storm signal number 2 up over the Philippine province of Batanes due to Typhoon Henry. Strong winds, along with moderate to at times intense rains, are being experienced there. Classes and government work have been suspended. The local government of Batanes is on alert for possible flooding and landslides.
Medyo malakas ang ulan ngayon. Malalaki na rin ang alon sa aming mga kargatan. Hindi kami nagpapakampante. Sa kasalukuyan, wala pa namang naiulat na mga nasirang tahanan, ari-arian o mga infrastruktura.
Typhoon Henry continues to weaken as it moves over the Philippine Sea. Aside from Batanes, signal number 1 is also up over the Babuyan Islands and the northeastern portion of mainland Cagayan. Moderate to heavy rains are expected over those areas. Henry is forecast to exit the Philippines Saturday evening or Sunday morning. The Philippine Disaster Management Agency also on alert for Typhoon Henry. The National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council says areas in the path of the storm have been reminded to make the necessary preparations. It adds relief assistance and standby funds are readily available for those who may be affected by the typhoon.
Since August 31, ay tuloy-tuloy yung ating pagbigay ng mga abiso sa mga LGUs. And so far, maganda naman ang mga reports na natatanggap natin. Lahat po ay nakahanda, lahat po ay nag-anticipate dito sa epekto ng bagyo. As far as major infrastructures, wala po tayong nakikitang major damage dito kasi medyo malayo siya. So kasi ang threat lang talaga dito ay yung malakas na hangin, yung dagat, no, maalon, and of course yung pag-ulan doon sa areas na yan. But tingnan pa rin natin yung epekto ng habagat na pwedeng dalhin nitong Henry, lalo na sa Regions 1 and CAR. So yun po, babantayan natin yan.
A landslide in Ifugao leaves at least one person dead. The landslide happened Thursday following heavy rains caused by Typhoon Henry. Authorities say the 37-year-old man was staying at the house of his brother when the incident happened. The mayor of Masantol in Pampanga seeking the help of the national government to deal with severe flooding. 22 out of 26 villages there remain flooded. 19 out of the town's 28 schools also inundated.
We're appealing to the national government to put us under the magnifying glass and silipin po ang bayan ng Masantol and to consider us as one of the towns in our in the country na talagang nangangailangan po ng national government agents intervention. And we've asked them, we've appealed to them na kung pwede, huwag po nating i-risk ang ating mga educators, huwag po nating i-risk ang ating mga mag-aaral. Kung pwede, let's shift back to blended learning. Huwag po natin pilitin yung face-to-face kung talagang di kailangan at kung talagang nasa peligro po ang ating mga mag-aaral at mga educators.
Turning now to the sugar importation mess, Senator Rizzo Ontiveros says the continued absence of Executive Secretary Vic Rodriguez in their probe sets a dangerous precedent. Ontiveros fears this may embolden other officials of the executive branch to snub future Senate hearings.
I join my minority leader, Senator Coco, that E.S. Rodriguez must face the committee. Bakit siya bibigyan ng exemption? No? First 100 days pa lang, may excuse letter na kaagad. I mean, anong kinatatakutan niya? What information is he hiding? What information doesn't he want the public to know? I want to find out from him what his take is on the conflicting stories about how the president found out about the draft sugar order number 4. Is it true that the president with the ES only found out about it on the SRA website? Or, as the former SRA officials say, that they personally, Yusek Sebastian in particular, personally informed the president about the sugar order.
Senator Ontiveros adds, someone in Malacañang must be held accountable.
buck should stop in Malacanang because the executive secretary was involved at certain points of the process, but unfortunately wouldn't allow the Blue Ribbon to complete the picture. Andito tayo sa gitna ng isang food crisis. Economists warn us not to allow it to degenerate into a food catastrophe. The president has to be better served by his executive secretary or by his cabinet, by the office of the ES getting its act together.